Hello and welcome to Ecoholics. In this video, we will discuss about Harrod-Doomer model. Now, this model is very important for any competitive examination because in any examination, whether you're giving Indian Economic Service, Economics Optional, RBI DEPR or UGC NET, GATE Economics or any exam, question will come from this topic. That is why a lot of students requested me to make this video. So here we'll see some of the introduction and this will be a three-part series. So here in this video, we will discuss about the basic introduction of Harrod-Doomer model. And in the next two series, next two videos, we'll discuss Harrod model separately and Doomer model separately. So let's begin. Now, Harrod-Doomer model given by two different economists, Roy Harrod and Eve C. Doomer. So these two, they were working differently in a different part of the world. Harrod was working in United Kingdom and Doomer on the same thing working in United States of America. That is why their model, although differ in details, but their main objective is same. Now, what is the main objective? Main objective is to achieve the steady state growth rate. This is the main objective, that an economy has to achieve a steady state growth rate. For that, they have given the model for advanced capitalist economies. Okay. So for advanced capitalist economy, it means developed countries. So this model is only for the developed countries. Now we'll see one by one what are the important elements of this model and how they have concluded that how any economy will achieve the steady state growth. On the same lines, we are living in India and we are also concerned with growth. So growth is a very important part of an economy. Now, whenever we see growth, even in daily life, we want steady state growth. What does it mean? It means growth must be like this. Okay, it should not be like this. Lots of ups and downs. So we always prefer this kind of growth, not this kind of growth. So this model explains how we can achieve that. Let's see. Now, under Harrod-Doomer model, two important things. First thing is that they have given the dual effect. Okay, dual effect of investment. Now, you know, if you want to grow at a steady state, you need investment. Now, what is investment in simple language? It is net addition to the stock of capital. So you need capital and capital comes from saving. So saving, then we have capital, stock of capital, and then we convert into investment. So investment is nothing, just the net addition in the stock of capital. Now, what is the dual effect of investment that they have explained? One is income effect. Okay, which is generally known as demand effect as well. Okay. And the second effect that they have given is capacity effect. Okay, capacity effect. This is also known as supply effect or supply side perspective. Now, I'll ask you one important question in the comment section. I would love that if you will give the answer to this question. If I'll ask Harrod-Doomer model, is inclined towards Keynesian economics or the classical economics? This you have to answer in the comment section. Okay, so just pause the video and try to answer that. Okay, I hope you have got the answer correct. Now, income and capacity effect, two effect. One we can say demand side and one is supply side. These two are very important. So we'll see one by one, okay. Now, first of all, you remember that if we see demand side and supply side, two things comes into mind. So if I'll write here demand and here I'll write supply. Now, whenever I write a demand, Keynes comes into the picture or into my mind. And when we talk about supply, the classical economist comes into my mind. Okay, so Harrod-Doomer took both sides. The demand side and the supply side. Demand side, very important. They have explained investment. They have explained the marginal propensity to consume. So Harrod-Doomer model is, we can say, the extension of the Keynesian model. Now, when you talk about Keynes, here I'll write. Keynes talked about short run. So Keynes talked about short run. It means the famous quote of John Maynard Keynes that in the long run, we are all dead. So that's why he talked only about short run, nothing about long run. Why? There's a simple issue behind that, because he was solving the problem of 1930s Great Depression. And that was a short run problem. Like, for example, in 2020, COVID was a problem. Now, if we see COVID, the short run problem is what? We have to arrange masks, sanitizer, PPE kit. This is a short run problem. What are the long run problem? The healthcare infrastructure. We need hospitals, beds, more number of doctors. This is a long term problem. So Keynes was dealing with the short run problem because Great Depression was the immediate problem. So that is why he took only the short run. So what Herod Domer did, they have extended this model. Extended to long run. Now, when I talk about classical economists, okay, in the classical economists, they always talk about long run, they always talk about full employment and these kind of things. And for them, the supply side is a major factor in determining the income and employment, as we have seen in the macroeconomics. So supply side effect is all about full employment. Okay, now in the full employment, what they have done, they have given more importance to the capital accumulation. This is the major, we can say, contribution of the classical economist. So what Herod Domer did, they have combined these two and extended to the long run setting. Okay, where marginal propensity to consume is constant in the short run, and in the supply side, they have reached the full employment equilibrium level by giving the opportunity for an economy to achieve the steady state growth. Now, last point in the introduction of the Herod Domer model. Now, there are certain things that economies are avoiding, okay, or avoiding, we can say, averting. There's a more correct word. First thing is secular inflation, and the next thing is secular stagnation. Now, these two things economies are avoiding. What does it mean? Now, understanding very carefully, secular inflation, here the word secular is very important to understand. It is not like political science secularity, okay, that state has no religion. Here the secular word means long term. So what economies are doing? Economies are averting or avoiding secular inflation or secular stagnation. Secular inflation means for a long term high rise in the prices. Secular stagnation means economy is at stagnant place. It means high unemployment. So this is the or low GDP or stable GDP. So these are the two things that economies are avoiding. So I hope you understood the introduction part of Herod Domer model. In the next lecture, we will see the full model of Herod, and the next lecture we'll discuss about Domer. Or first we'll study Domer, then we'll go to Herod, and then we'll say what are the knife edge equilibrium, what are the three types of growth that they have given, like warranted growth rate, natural growth rate, and the actual growth rate. So we'll see. I hope you liked it, you know, and we'll meet in the next lecture. So don't forget to like this video. If you like it, you can share with your friends as well, so that they also get the benefit from this lecture. And don't forget to subscribe Ecoholics. For more information, you can visit our website or download the mobile app. You can also contact on my WhatsApp number for any query related to examinations like Economics Optional, Indian Economic Service, UGC NET, RBI, DEPR, and many other competitive examination where economics is important. Because this topic, Herod Domer, is the most important topic under growth and development and economics. We also provide live courses, live classes. You'll get study material. You'll get unlimited doubt facilities. So all the things given in detail in the description of this video. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.